Students, welcome to our e-vidya classes. Dear students, in previous classes we have all discussed about the movement of earth womb. Okay, now we are going to discuss about snail student. Okay, we will look at how a snail will be moved. So collect a snail from a garden. Have you ever seen round structure it carries on its back? You can see this picture, how a snail structure. Okay, you might have seen this type of snail also. So we will discuss how they are movement. Okay, so students, before going to explain, I will tell you, I will read one by one sentence which is very important, and I will give short note also. You have to write down and you try to understand what I am going to explain. Okay, so this is called the shell. Okay, that rounded structure is called shell, and it is the outer skeleton of the snail. But it is not made of bones. The shell is a single unit and does not help in moving from one place to another. While you are looking, students, what is you are observing here? It is not a bone. Okay, it is a shell. It is a single shell. It does not help to move one place to another place. It has two tracked elements. Place the snail on a glass plate and watch it. When it starts moving, carefully lift the glass plate along with the snail over your head. Okay, observe its movement from the beneath. A thick structure and thread, a head of the snail may come out of the opening in the shell. The thick structure is its foot, made of strong muscle. Now carefully tilt the glass plate, and the wavy motion of the foot can be seen. The movement of the snail slow or fast as you to an earthworm. Okay, how a earthworm will be moved? According to that, snail also like this they will move. But now it is time to compare which movement is slow or fast. Okay, that is snail or earthworm. Understood, students? So it is one single celled. I will tell you, students. Then, and I will give you also the about short notes about these all the things you have to write down. Now we will come to our cockroach. Okay, the movement of cockroach, students. Cockroach walks and climbs as well as fly in their air. They have three pairs of legs. So cockroach have three pairs of legs. Student, where I am putting underline, you have to put also. It is very important, students. This helps in walking. Three pairs of legs are there. Means six legs are there. The body is covered with a hard outer skeleton. You can see that is a hard outer covered skeleton. This outer skeleton is made of different joints together, and that permits movement. Okay, that is permits movement. There are two pairs of wings attached to the breast. There are two pair of wings are attached to their breast, means chest. The cockroach have the distinct muscles. Those near the legs move to the leg for walking. The breast muscle move the wings. The breast muscle will help to wings them the cockroach flies. Okay, so the breast muscle move their wings to cockroach flies. Clear, students? Now we will come to students, birds. Okay, you might have seen different types of birds, and you can see here, students, this is the image of the bird. This is the skeleton of a bird. Okay, how you know that how the skeleton of our, in previous classes we have discussed the skeleton of our body like this. The birds have also skeleton. Okay, you can see here. So students, now we will come to birds. So how birds can fly or they can move? So birds fly in the air and they walk on the ground. You might have seen these kinds of birds. Those birds, they can fly in the air and walk on the ground. Some birds like dogs and swan also swim in water. The birds can fly because their body are well suited for flying. Why they are well suited? Because they are very light. their body, their bones are hollow and light. This is very important, student. Okay, and where I am putting underline, student, you have to focus these lines. The bones are hollow and the light, so they can fly easily on the sky. The bones of the hind limbs are typically for walking and perching. The bony parts of the forelimbs are modified as wings. You can see this is the wings of the birds. This is the skeleton of a bird. So that is called forelimbs are modified as wings. When the birds grow up, their forelimbs are modified to as wings. Okay. So the shoulder bones are strong and the breast bones are modified to hold muscle to fly. Okay. So here point it is important, students. The shoulder bones are strong. Okay. But the breast bones which are modified to the hold muscles to fly, which are used to move the wings up and down. Okay. When you can see, students. You might have seen when a bird move on the sky, they will fly up and down and in each and every direction. So how it is possible? Because of their breast bone. Okay, that breast bone which will be modified to hold the muscles of flight, which are used to move the wings up and down. Okay, so the breast bone will be help them to move up and down. Understood? So this type. For this kind of feature, a bird can move, they can walk on the ground also. Understood? So I can show here, student. See, which is some important point about the birds. Dog and swan swim in water. Bones are hollow. The bird's bones are hollow. Forelimbs are modified to wings, and the breast bones are hold muscle of flight, which has to wing the up and down. So the breast bone is modified to hold the muscle, which is hold the muscle of flight, which has the wings up and down. Understood? This is a very short important point which I written, so you have to write down. Okay, first you have to read the books, then you have to write down. Clear? Now we will come to fish. How a fish can move in water. Okay. Have you ever noticed that shape of a boat is somewhat like a fish? The head and tail of a fish are smaller than the middle portion of the body. It is clear that the head and tail, you can see, students, the head and tail, this is the head and tail are little bit they are smaller as compared to the middle portion. The body tapers at both ends. This body shape is called streamline. So what is streamline shape? You can see, students, how this type of structure is called streamline. Okay, because when they will move, the water will be moved this side and this side, so that is called streamline. The shape is such that water can flow around it easily and allow the fish to move in water. Because of this kind of shape, a fish can move easily inside the water. So this kind of shape is called streamline shape. Understood? First look at this fish image, then you can easily understood that this type of shape is called streamline shape. The skeleton of fish is covered with strong muscle. During swimming, the muscle mass make the front part of the body curve to one side and the tail part swings towards the opposite side. Okay, when a fish can move, the front part will be curved to one side and the tail part swings towards the opposite side. The fish forms a curve as shown in figure 8.23. See how when a fish will be moved, how they can make a curve like structure. Okay, which help them to move towards ahead. Okay, the tail part swings toward the opposite side. Quickly the body and tail curve the other side. This makes a jerk and pushes the body forward. So when they will move this time, the body will make a curve like structure, which helps them, or which helps them a jerk and pushes the body forward, through which they can move forward by jerking their body. Okay, a series of such jerks make a fish swim ahead. Means this is the continuous process, student. Okay, a jerk will be created, then they will push their body forward. So it will go to fast this like this. So that means it is a continuous process which helps them to move inside the water. So this helps the fins of the tail. This is helped by the fins of the tail. You can see this is called a fin, student. Okay, this is called fins of a fish. So that is helps a fish to move on the water. So short note will write, both the fish and both the end of a fish are trapped safe. This is called streamlined. Okay, fins on their body helps to keep balance of their body and to keep the direction while swimming. Okay, and this part is called. So student, by this process a fish can move inside water. Okay, so fish also have the other fins on their body which mainly help them to keep the balance of the body. So you can see, student, this is the image of the fish. So these part are called fins of the fish, which helps them to balance in their water, balance their body in water, okay, while swimming. So did you ever notice the underwater, the divers wear fin like flippers on their feet to help them move easily in the water. Okay, if you might have seen sometimes a Discovery Channel or some the person who will be discover about inside the sea water, very deep sea water, they will discover different kinds of plants and fish. When they will go inside with the help of they will use the flippers. What flippers on their feet? It still looks like the fins of the fish. So because it will help them to swimming inside the deep water. Okay, students. So now we will come to our, how do snake move? So we discussed about cockroach, birds, fish. So now it is time for how do snakes move. So everyone, we have seen the snake. So now we will study how a snake can move. So snakes have a long backbone. So snakes, you can see the image, a snakes have a long backbone inside their body. This is have a snakes have the long backbone. Okay, they have many thin muscles. They are connected to each other even though they are far from any one another. Okay, they have very thin muscle. They are connected each other. This is the snake, student, and the inside that muscle, the inside their body muscles are connected to each other. Okay, and muscles are also interconnected the backbone and ribs and skin. Okay, so the muscles and the backbone, they are interconnected, and the rib and skin, so all are interconnected each other. The snake's body curves into many loops. The snake's body curves into many loops like this, students. Okay, loops. Each loop of the snake gives it a forward push by pressing against the ground. Okay, so these loop, what will help? It will give the forward push like this. Okay, by pressing against the ground. So that is called because of loops. And the since it is long body makes many loops, each loops give it this push. Snakes moves forward very fast and not in a straight line. Okay, so because of their loops, and this will a snake can move by forward, okay, by pushing against the ground, so that they cannot move with a straight line. Okay, whenever you might have seen, when a snake will move, they cannot move straight line, their body will be like this while moving. Okay, so we have learned about the use of bones and muscles for movement of their different animals. So Pehli and Bhojo have many questions in their about the different movement in animals. So we must
यू हैव बीन अनएंसर्ड एंड क्वेश्चंस बॉजिंग इन योर माइंड. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो दिस इज अबाउट द आवर बॉडी मूवमेंट. सो आई विल शो यू द स्टूडेंट्स. आई रिटन सम नो शॉर्ट नोट्स व्हिच यू हैव कैन ऑल्सो राइट फ्रॉम दिस नोटबुक. ओके, बट यू हैव टू प्रिफर द बुक्स एंड यू हैव टू रीड द बुक्स अगेन एंड अगेन. ओके, सो आई रिटन अबाउट सम व्हिच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट अबाउट दिस टॉपिक. सो फर्स्ट वन आई सेड दिस इज द कॉकरोच अर्थवर्म, देन स्नेल, कॉकरोच, बर्ड्स, फिश एंड स्नेक्स. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट आवर दिस टॉपिक. So if you want, you can copy from here and you have to write the notebook also on your notebook. So next class we will discuss the question answer, students. So thank you. Take care.